lithium hydride, there is some mistake in there. Lithium hydride. Open lithium hydride. Open lithium hydride.
Yes, sir.
The mistake is there in the diagram. Make a correction of the diagram or take a rewrite the diagram one more. Just find a small space. Take small space to strike up the diagram. Diagram is not correct. You have to write actually first I written hydrogen and lithium. First you write lithium and followed by hydrogen. Lithium hydride structure. Lithium hydride, one rod and diagram. Molecular order diagram, lithium hydride. There is a mistake in there. Here I written hex, here I written lithium. That is not correct. First lithium you have to write. This is 1s2, this is 3s1. Lithium. This is 1s1. This is the actual diagram. There is some mistake. Please correct this particular diagram. This one. Sigma BMO, sigma star ABMO. 1 and 1 electrons. 2. Same thing. Here I get HR. Here I get lithium. Actually, lithium should be here. 1s2, anyhow, not participating. 1s2. I did not write 1s2 for lithium. Bond order. This is what 2. 2 minus 0 by 2 equal to 1. Small correction is there in the diagram, make it. Next. Come to continuation of dipole moment. Place it there or not, I also asked you to leave at the last. After completing chemical bonding, also you left some place. So if after dipole moment some place is there, then you continue. Come to dipole moment, place it there, you continue there. Calculation of is very, very important. Calculation of is it completed, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Did I remove? Right. Come on, come to dipole moment question 8. Right. Calculation of percentage of fraction of percentage of fraction of electronic charge, fraction of electronic charge or percentage of ionic character. Percentage of ionic character equal to dipole moment into 100 by bond length into Q. Now, if mu is given, if dipole moment, if mu is given in divide, then we is taken in gives to CM. blue is given in divide, compulsory the blue should be taken in ES to CM. 2 is electron in charge, B bond length. Eight bond length will be taken in centimeters. Centimeters. Two is electronic charge. Electronic charge. If it is given in dipole length, electronic charge should be ES2. Compulsory ES2. Then you are acquiring 4.8 at the power of minus 10 ES2 okay. Electronic charge should be. Now, if device given, device given in device, it should be ES2 here. Bond length should be in couple centimeters. Electronic charge, two standard electronic charge should be ES2 and 4.8 at the power of minus 10. Suppose if 2 is given. Is given in Coulomb centimeters, CM suppose, Coulomb's meter length. Coulomb's meter. Coulomb's meter. That is CM. That is CM. Then bond length should be in meters. Bond length should be in meters. Two should be in. Coulombs. Electronic charge should be in coulombs. According to the information given the problem, accordingly how to apply these particular values, corresponding units, and how to do it. Very very important problems. Every other question appearing in emails or. Right, advanced. Right. So let's do two problems. Come on. A diatomic molecule. A diatomic molecule has dipole moment of has a dipole moment of 1.2 divide. Say the unit divide 1.2 divide. If the bond distance bond length equal to 1 angstrom. Bond length equal to 1 angstrom. What fraction of electronic charge? What fraction of electronic charge on each atom? Electronic charge on each atom are percentage of ionic character. First one I will show, remaining you do. Okay. First one I am showing, come on. Percentage of ionic character or fraction of electronic charge. Percentage of ionic character equal to U. U is given in 1.2 divided. So 1.2 into 10 to the power of minus 18. Yes, you see here. And so maybe the percentage is 100. So maybe the percentage is 100. Bond length, 1 angstrom. It should be taken in centimeters. 1 into 10 to the power of minus 8. 2 electronic charge. 2 electronic charge. Yes, you. So electronic charge of electron 4.8 10 to the power of minus 10. Yes, you. Yes, come on. want to say how much fraction of electronic charge is percentage. First you get fraction, next percentage. Fraction of electronic charge is percentage. What is the answer over here?
Sir, 25, sir.
25 is the percentage I carry. Our fraction of electronic charge comes to be 0.25. Okay? Fraction of electronic charge, 0.25. What percentage you say? Percentage of fraction of electronic charge, 25. Next one. Next problem. Then you have to do. Shailaja, do it. Shailaja, are you there in the class? Ah. Shailaja, are you there in the class or not? Shailaja, are you not there?
Yes.
Ah, come on. Take the problem, do it. A slightly polar molecule, AB has dipole moment 0.24 divide. Bond length 1 angstrom. Calculate fraction of electronic charge for ionic character. Do it. 2 minutes time. Come on. All of you do it. Let us say the answer, not others. Completed Shailaja, got it? Completed. Come on, all of you, any other? Come on. Ah.
Sir, 5%, sir.
5%, sir.
5%, sir.
5%, right? 5% only. 5% fraction of electronic charge, 0.05 percent. fraction of electronic drop. Even percentage of electronic drop 5%, percentage of ion is 5%, fraction of electron drop 0.05. This is correct answer. Next one. A molecule AB has, next question. A molecule AB has bond length. Bond length 6.617 angstroms. 1.617 angstroms. Dipole moment 0.38 divide. Then calculate percentage ionic character per fraction of electronic charge. Fraction of electronic charge. Bagalkot Revant. Revant, are you there in the class?
Yes, sir. 1 minute. Sir, is it 4%, sir?
Chodo, careful ga. That's it. All of you.
4.9%.
What? 4.9.
Yes, sir. 4.9.
5% approximate. Okay.
Okay, sir.
5%. Okay.
Okay,
yes, sir.
5% or fraction is what? 0.05%. Fraction is 0.05. Next up. Dipole moment of lithium hydride 1.964 into 10⁻²⁹ coulombs meter. Dipole moment of lithium hydride 1.964 10⁻²⁹ coulombs meter. The unit is changed, coulombs meter. Bond length. Nine six angstrom. What is the percentage of ionic character? And the fraction of electronic charge. Shivasai, are you there in the class? Shivasai. Ah. Shivasai. Mr. Shubham. Shubham. Rohan Krishna. Rohan. Come on, do it. Ability change is very careful. According to that, you are today. Electronic charge, coulombs you have to take. The previous case you have taken ES2, but you have to take now coulombs. The corresponding unit, corresponding the bond length, you have to take and do it. 3 minutes time I am giving to you.
Sir, G we have to, I mean Q we have to take in coulombs, na sir?
Ah, coulombs is fine. Enta coulombs dhali enta?
10 power minus 19, sir.
Value, electronic, coulombs value enta?
Minus 1.9 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb.
1.9.
Sir, 1.6, I think.
1.6 ra bahu.
1.6 into 10 to the power
1.6 ra. Ir ni achuna ra atomic structure lo. Only values gurtunchukovali. Instead of 1.6, you are taking 1.9 and gone. Everything is gone. Only values gurtunchukovali. Rohan Krishna, are you doing? Rohan? Rohan Krishna?
Doing, sir. One second.
Do it.
So, sir, 77%.
76.82. 76.82%. Yes, as you said, 77%. Fraction of electronic charge, what to say? It is what 7.77. These are very important problems. These three or four problems are given. These are repeatedly appearing in the same members in the entrance exam. Right? Very careful. The unit is given in DeBye, the unit is given in CM. Accordingly, how to take electronic charge and bond lengths, accordingly, how to solve the problem, to be careful. When a coulombs is given, coulombs unit is given, take the electron in coulombs, bond length in meters. Whenever DeBye is given, take the same DeBye in ES CM, that is minus 18, and bond length should be in angstrom, bond length should be in centimeters, and electronic charge should be in ESC. According to the units you have to take and do. If you are going wrong taking the units, you keep going wrong. Right. So this, while I am closing, chemical bonding, all the types of questions, each and every concept, everything I given. Right. This completes everything in chemical bonding, including questionnaire. You read my notes, read my questionnaire, go to any examination. Right. Right, very sharp, regular class, come on, regular class. Chemical bonding completed, very sharp, regular class, come on.
Sir, we were right.
Started water.
Water, hydrates, no?
Yes, sir.
Come on, types of hydrates. Types of hydrates. Types of hydrates. Do it. Okay, first one. Take a book. Coordinated hydrates. Coordinated hydrates, see the word. Suppose you are taking compound like CR, H2O, 10-6, plus 3. This is known as coordinated hydrate. In this molecule, the water molecules are coordinated to chromium plus 3, see the word. Chromium plus 3. The 6 water molecules, 6 bar now, therefore you know, octane geometry. Like this, water molecules are bonded by coordinate covalent bond. Coordinate covalent bond to this particular chromium. Therefore, this particular compound, what you call coordinated hydrate, we call coordinated hydrate. This is the thing. Come on, first one. Coordinated hydrate. Example. Coordinated hydrate. Example, take the structure. You know well, 6 bonds, octahedral.
Yes, sir.
1 minute, sir.
1 minute.
Right. The above compound. Water molecules are bonded to chromium plus 3. Chromium plus 3 by coordinate covalent bond. Therefore, it is known as coordinate hydrate. Second one. Interstitial hydrates. Example. Barium chloride, 2H2O. See the word. Barium chloride, 2H2O. See the word. This particular molecule, in between the BACL2 molecules, that what are intermolecular spaces or occupied by water molecules. This particular molecule, in between the interspecies of intermolecular spaces, BACL2, intermolecular spaces occupied by water molecules. Therefore, these are known this particular compound, what you call interstitial hydrate. That's all. Write down. Take the structure. Example structure. completed?
No, sir. Wait.
Completed, sir.
Right. Madam, in this compound, water molecules occupy intermolecular spaces. Intermolecular spaces. Therefore, this compound is known as interstitial hydrate. Interstitial hydrate. Next. Coordinated and hydrogen bonded hydrate. This is very important. It will be there in every entrance. It is appearing in every entrance. Directly or indirectly in every entrance, this question will be there. Look here. Coordinated in hydrate, hydrogen bonded hydrate. Example. With the board. Very, very best example. Proper percentage 5H2O. With the board. Structure. Copper is split pena. Split pena. In this, with the board. Don't write. Try to understand. Then you can write. No writing. Look here. Coordinated. Therefore, coordinated. Then, this field will not complex. Field will not. Field will not. Sulfate will not. Sulfate is outside. Only four water molecules now. One more is hydrogen bonded to this particular. Sulfate ion. Outside the molecule, outside the coordination sphere, we call this coordination sphere, outside the coordination sphere, one more water molecule. Therefore, coordinated. Hydrogen bonded. Therefore, coordinated, hydrogen bonded, hydrate. Very, very best example. Next up, see, in this compound, how many types of bonds are there? Can you see? Come on, check. How many types of bonds are occurring?
Two types.
Types of bonds.
Three.
Only three? See, within the water molecule, covalent bond. Right? And water molecule to copper plus two, coordinate covalent bond. Bracket to sulfate.
Ionic bond.
Ionic bond. What is this bond?
Hydrogen bond.
This is the molecule carrying all the types of bonds. Covalent bond, coordinate bond,
ionic bond, hydrogen bond.
So this is a question will appear in every entrance examination, directly or indirectly. So be very, very careful. There I put three stars and tick mark also. Every entrance, this question will be there. Take it. Take it. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Right. Evo compound, right on. Evo compound. Four water molecules are bonded to. Four water molecules are bonded to copper plus two. Copper plus two. Four water molecules are bonded to copper plus two by covalent bond. Covalent bond. Next, one water molecule. One water molecule bonded by hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond. Outside the coordination sphere. This is called a sphere. Outside the coordination sphere. Coordination sphere. Therefore, it is known as coordinated hydrogen bonded hydrate. Hydrogen bonded hydrate. Next, in this molecule, coordinate covalent bonds, ionic bonds. And hydrogen bond is there. Hydrogen bond is there. Hydrogen bond is there. Hydrogen is very, very important, I said. Then, recently a question appeared by giving simply about the barium chloride 2H2O. About the barium chloride 2H2O. Last year or before last year, a question appeared in GMAX. They are given a paragraph, a compound XCB, it is carrying certain number of water molecules, barium is it. A compound X, barium chloride, carrying certain number of water molecules, it is having certain weight W1, and on heating it is losing weight and getting what W2, and the difference between W1 and W2 is so and so. Then, what is the formula of barium chloride they are given? What is the formula of barium chloride? Barium chloride formula is what BaCl2H2O. But there is actually, they are given many parameters. And students struggle to get it because W1, W2 difference and all, they have to calculate and get the how many water molecules barium chloride is having. If you remember, the barium chloride carrying only two water molecules, it is always dihydrate only, two molecules. By looking the answers, barium chloride 2H2O, barium chloride 4H2O, barium chloride 6H2O. By looking the answer, you can easily say barium chloride 2H2O. Without taking the calculation part, you can easily understand barium chloride always carry only two water molecules. This is what barium chloride is. Remember this particular BaCl2H2O. Question appeared on this by giving a paragraph. So many informations are given. Then lastly, they are put a question. What is the formula of barium chloride hydrate? Barium chloride hydrate. Barium chloride only carrying 2H2O. If you know the formula, without doing any calculation, you can easily make out. So this is the question that appeared in the recent exam. Very careful, BaCl2, 2H2O only. Right. Come on next. Types of water, actually. Types of water. like soft water, hot water, novel. The water which we really use, froth. Water which we really use, froth. That is actually known as water, soft water. This water which easily use, froth and soap. That particular water, what you call? Soft water. Soft water, free from any minerals. It is pure water, no minerals are present in that. Hard water. The water which cannot give, easy froth with soap. That is known as water, hard water. Hardness of water is due to magnesium and calcium salts. Magnesium and calcium salts like either it may be magnesium bicarbonate, calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate, and calcium sulfate. So, hot water. The water which will not give free lather or froth with soap, what you call hot water. Hardness of water is due to different calcium and magnesium salts, calcium and magnesium bicarbonate, calcium and magnesium chloride, calcium and magnesium sulfates. Sulfates. These are the reason for this particular hardness of water. Why the hard water cannot give free lather with soap? Why are upunilu? The bore water doesn't give any froth with the bore water. Upunilu, ground water, doesn't give any froth with the soap. Why? What is happening now? What is soap? Soap is this one, the word. Soap is calcium salt of fatty acid. Calcium salt of long chain fatty acid. Calcium salt of long chain fatty acid. It is sodium salt of stearic acid. Sodium salt of palmitic acid, sodium salt of oleic acid. I'm writing sodium salt of stearic acid. I'm writing. Now it is C17, H35, COOH. This is what COOH. This is COOH. This is soap. Sodium salt of stearate. This is soap. Actually sodium salt of stearic acid, let me say stearate, sodium salt of stearic acid, sodium salt of stearic acid. You see C17 is that by COOH, stearic acid, sodium salt, no, sodium salt of stearic acid. This whenever it is reacting with water, hot water. Hot water carrying calcium and magnesium salt. Whenever it reacts with calcium and magnesium salt, the soap is getting precipitated. What is calcium plus 2? Or you consider Mg plus 2? This is what hot water. Then what you are getting? This is converting into C17, H35, COOH. This is actually 2 moles today. 2 moles. This is calcium salt of soap, calcium salt of stearic acid, and calcium soap. This calcium soap is insoluble in water. Therefore, hot water, whenever coming in contact with soap, the calcium plus two, reacting with water, soap. And the soap is getting precipitated. Because of this reason, hard water do not give free lather with soap. Right on. Soft water. The water which gives free lather with soap. Free lather. Free lather. Nether means growth, Nether means soap. Soft water is free from impurities. Soft water free from impurities. Impurities. Next. Hot water. Come on, fast. Hot water.
There are some disturbances are there, sir.
The water which cannot give free later with soap known as hard water. The hardness of water is due to presence of magnesium and calcium salts like right now. Magnesium bicarbonate, calcium bicarbonate, magnesium chloride, calcium chloride, sulfate. Update. Update.
No, sir, 1 minute.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right, next.
Yes, sir.
When hard water reacts with the soap, it converts into calcium soap. Nishant. Some disturbance. Right, come on. Are you listening properly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, come on. When hard water reacts with soap, it converts into calcium soap or magnesium soap. Calcium soap or magnesium soap, which is insoluble precipitate. Therefore, hot water cannot give. Hot water cannot give free later soap. Free later soap. Take it. So, sodium salt. citric acid, hard water. Hot water, and some salt of soap. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Right. Types of hotness. Types of hotness. One. See the board. Temporary hardness. Permanent hardness. Look here. Temporary hardness. Permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. Hardness. See. Temporary hardness of water is due to bicarbonate salts. It may be magnesium, white carbonate, calcium, white carbonate. Next, permanent hardness is due to magnesium chloride, calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate, calcium sulfate. Next, come on, temporary hardness. Temporary hardness of water is due to presence of magnesium and calcium bicarbonate salts. Magnesium and calcium bicarbonate salts. Come on, magnesium bicarbonate, calcium bicarbonate. Calcium bicarbonate. Next, permanent hardness. Right. Permanent hardness of water is due to. Permanent hardness of water is due to. Water is due to. Presence of magnesium and calcium. Magnesium and calcium. Fluoride and sulfate salts. Again. Sulfate salts. Next, removal of hardness of order. Removal of hardness of order. Removal of hardness of order. First one. Removal of temporary hardness. Removal of temporary hardness. Temporary hardness. Look here. First one. Winding. Winding. Second one. Second one. Slag splitter. See the board, don't break. Slag splitter. Third one. Third one. Addition of complexing. Complexing are chelating agents. Chelating agents. See the word. The three ways you can remove temporary hardness. One is simply boiling. Second one is Clark's method. Third one is what? Addition of complexing or chelating agents. Then we discuss. Boiling. Hey. The hot water carry bicarbonate salt. Just take the water, go on boil it. The bicarbonate decompose, produce either hydroxide precipitate or carbonate precipitate. They are getting precipitated. By filtration, they can be removed. See the board. Now, suppose temporary hardness is due to either bicarbonate, potassium bicarbonate, or calcium. Bicarbonate. This you are boiling. Then, this is actually decomposing, producing magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide inside level, settling at the bottom. Then, you are getting what still? It is decomposing, producing CO2 plus H2O. CO2 plus H2O. This magnesium hydroxide gets precipitated. Then take the water and filter up. You can remove magnesium part and the water you are getting is what? Free from magnesium bicarbonate. That is what subword. Now, calcium bicarbonate. Boil it again. Suppose instead of magnesium bicarbonate, the water is carrying calcium bicarbonate. Boil it, then it is decomposing but producing not the calcium hydroxide, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate, and again you are getting CO2, now you are getting H2O. Calcium carbonate also insoluble. You can filter, you can separate calcium carbonate, the remaining water free from calcium bicarbonate. So, magnesium, remember very carefully, magnesium bicarbonate and heating, you are getting magnesium hydroxide precipitate, so very careful. Calcium bicarbonate and heating, you are getting calcium carbonate. The magnesium hydroxide, calcium carbonate, both are insoluble. They can be removed and you are getting that soft water, the hard water converted to soft water. Easy method, quickly boil. But you remember, magnesium bicarbonate, use magnesium hydroxide. Calcium bicarbonate, use calcium carbonate. These 2 points should not forget. Come on. Boiling. The hot water carrying magnesium bicarbonate or calcium bicarbonate lithium bipharmate or calcium bipharmate on binding. On binding, magnesium bicarbonate decompose. Magnesium bicarbonate decompose produce magnesium hydroxide precipitate. Magnesium hydroxide precipitate. Magnesium hydroxide precipitate. If calcium bicarbonate is there, if calcium bicarbonate is there on binding, calcium bicarbonate gets precipitated. Calcium bicarbonate gets precipitated. Gets precipitated. These precipitates can be separated by filtration. Can be separated by filtration. By filtration. Filtration. As a result, hot water changes into soft water. Hot water changes into soft water. Take it. See, what you are getting precipitated, that's important. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Right. Look. Class. Class whether industrial metal it's very simple. The hot water carrying temporary hardness, calcium bicarbonate or lithium bicarbonate, that is added with the required amount of slake and lime or lime. Slake and lime or lime. See the word. Bicarbonate, we are adding slake lime. Slake lime means calcium hydroxide. Or you can add lime. Lime is simply calcium oxide. Also, calcium oxide will add into water that becomes calcium hydroxide. So, either of it you can add, you will know difference of. Then, this will be coagulated, heated. Then again, magnesium bicarbonate converts into magnesium hydroxide precipitate. Then, we are getting calcium carbonate, plus CO2, plus H2O. Like this, so magnesium hydroxide, calcium carbonate, both are inside. They can be separated. Then hot water converts into soft water. Now, suppose calcium bicarbonate, see the word. Calcium bicarbonate is made. You are adding slake and lime. You are adding slake and lime. Then you are heating it again. Then no hydroxide now. Completely converting into calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate plus 2H2O. Calcium carbonate plus 2H2O. Like this, calcium carbonate again precipitate by filtration to get separated. This I put here, industrial method. Industrial method. What industrial method? Generally, this is generally used in rice mills. Rice mills. You know, half boiled water. That's all. Half boiled rice, half boiled rice. Some of the industries, they actually take the rice, they actually half boil. They use very big tanks. But the tanks, they require large amount of water. The water should not be hard water. So to make it to soft water, they apply this particular method. This is what Clark's method, the industrial method. This is industrial method why we are generally using it. Mainly used for boiler purpose. For half boiling of rice, for a big boiler, they want to fill with water. The water should not be hot water. The water should be converted into soft water. That purpose is used. That's the initial method. And this is generally good for boiler purpose in the rice mills. Come on. In this Clark's method, required amount of slaked lime is added. Lime is added. Or bracket, calcium hydroxide or calcium oxide. In the bracket, in the normal way, calcium hydroxide is slaked lime. Lime is calcium oxide. Calcium hydroxide or calcium oxide in the bracket. Added and heated. Magnesium bicarbonate precipitated as magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium bicarbonate prepared in magnesium hydroxide. Calcium bicarbonate precipitated as calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate. These are insoluble. They can be separated. By this hard water converts into soft water. Take this equation. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Make a note. Clark's method is the industrial method used for boiler purpose. Boiler purpose. Third method, addition of complexing agents are chelating agents. Chelating agents. The bracket. Sequestration. Sequestration. What is complexing agent? What is chelating agent? Now, suppose you take this particular copper, for example, right? Copper plus. Copper plus two will react with ammonia. Ammonia is carrying one donor atom. They said yesterday, no, ligand. But I said ligand, ligand means? What is ligand?
Donor of electron.
Good. Electron pair donor. Very good. So copper plus two on reaction with what ammonia? You know, ammonia is carrying one donor pair. Even it is bonded to copper. In this way, it is bonded to copper. Right? This particular ammonia is known as now complexing agent. Complexing agent. Actually, not one ammonia molecule is linked. Nearly four ammonia molecules are linked to this particular, forming this particular complex. This particular complex. Just like I have shown hydrate, no? Similarly. Just like I showed you hydrate, similarly. Ammonia. Suppose simply TUCL, simple salt. This is four molecules are linked now. It is looking very complex in structure now. Complex. What do you call it? It is complex. Ammonia with copper is forming a complex. Therefore, ammonia is known as now
complexing agent.
Complexing agent. Very good. Complexing agent. So this is copper is linked to this particular ammonia molecules. This particular ammonia, what you call complexing agent. Now, ammonia molecule is carrying only one donor atom. In some cases, the ligand molecule carrying more than one donor atom. I'm writing one. See. This is ethylene diamine. This is ethylene, two amines. They are what you call ethylene diamine. This is known as ethylene diamine. So before going to actual subject, I have to teach what is actually complexing agent, what is actually chelating agent. Without explaining what is complexing agent, what is chelating agent, you cannot follow here anything. So I am explaining first what complexing agent, what is chelating agent. Now, copper is forming a compound, a big compound. Therefore, that is not a simple one, it is complex. Therefore, what? This is a complex. How it is formed? With ammonia. What do you call ammonia? It is ammonia is called complexing agent because it is forming a big compound of the complex. Now, in ammonia molecule, you are looking one donor, only one donor atom. That is known as monodentate, we call monodentate. Monodentate means only one donor. Here, how many donor atoms are there here?
Two, sir.
Two nitrogens, no? One nitrogen, one donor. Two nitrogens, two donors. What do you call this one? Bidentate. This one is bidentate. What is denticity? Number of donor atoms. What is denticity? Come on.
Number of donor atoms.
It is one monodentate. It is two. Come on.
Bidentate.
It is simply linking to the metal, not forming any ring. Not forming any ring. Suppose this is reacting with the copper plus two, then it is linked like this. First donor. Second donor. First donor, second donor. Come on, see what you are linking at above. Around the copper, now you are getting a ring. Now you are getting a ring. This is the copper. This is copper. This is ethylene dynamic. This is ethylene dynamic. This is linked to this particular copper. Then around copper are getting a ring. No, that ring is known as what? Chelate ring. That ring is known as, come on.
Chelate ring.
Chelate ring. That particular ethylene dynamic, what do you call? Chelating agent. Come on, what do you call?
Chelating agent.
Yes, you got now everything. So, some of the molecules, some of the ligands are having one donor. Some of the molecules having more than one donor. The two donor atoms are forming a bond with metal. Around the metal, you are getting what? A ring. Ring. This ring is known as what? Chelate ring. Then this particular, what do you call? Chelating agent. This is known as complexing agent. This is known as chelating agent. Now, once you are adding this particular complexing or chelating agents to the hard water, what are the complexing or chelating agents? First, to take what is the complexing agent, what is chelating agent, then I explain the remaining part. Take it. First, write this one. Copper plus 2 plus 4NH3. 4 and 4NH3. Write this. Complex. Completed.
Yes.
Right. Right here. NH3 is known as complexing agent. Complexing agent. Next. This one right here. Right. Ethylene dynamic. This is ethylene dynamic. Right. Right on. Carrying two donor atoms, can form a ring around the metal ion. That ring is known as chelate ring.
Sir, chelate spelling?
Zero in the question. Wrong again. Chelate. Chelating agents. Chelate. C-H-V-L-A-T. Chelate. Ringer. Chelate. What are written? Say. What are written?
That ring is known as chelate ring.
Chelate ring, right. Come on, take it. Chelate ring and the ligand. Ligand is known as chelate ligand. one copper plus two, ethylene diamine, this is what, chelate ring.
Also 1 minute. Completed, sir.
So I want to give an idea for a complex ingredient which is forming a complex. If it is carrying one donor, that is monodentate. If it is carrying two donors, that is bidentate. Then bidentate again generally forming ring around the metal ion. That ring is known as what the chelate ring. And the agent, the ligand, what you call chelating ligand recall. So what is the heading here? Addition of complex ingredients or chelating agents. So some of the many are there, many chelating agents are there. Yes, I even want to make you to understand that there was to discuss anything about this particular ligand and types of ligand and all in second year. Very, very seriously, in second year we'll do it that all. Just I want to give an idea, what is complex ingredient, what is chelating agent. Chelating is addition of complex ingredients or chelating agent sequestration. So the complex or chelating agents are poly amino acids. Poly amino acids. Next, poly phosphates. And EDTA. EDTA. This is ethylene diamine. There are very big things. Ethylene diamine. Tetraacetate. These are all either complexing agents or chelating agents. Either polyamine acids, polyphosphates, ethylene diamine tetraacetate or EDTA is added to hard water. Added to hard water. Carrying calcium plus 2 and magnesium plus 2. That means what? Calcium bicarbonate or magnesium bicarbonate. Then these complexing agents. These complexing agents from donor atoms are there. No? Donor atoms are there. These donor atoms are forming a complex with calcium plus 2 like this. These donor atoms are linking with water, calcium plus 2. Just now what I found, copper plus 2 is linked to ethylene diamine. Similarly, this either amino acids, polyphosphates, ethylene diamine, tetraacetate or EDTA is forming a complex calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2. Or magnesium plus 2. And forming a soluble complex. This forming a complex, it is staying there only in the solution, in the water. It is there only in the water and forming a complex. By this, what you are observing, the activity of calcium plus 2, the activity of magnesium plus 2, completely suppressed or prevented. This prevention or suppression of activity of calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2, what to call sequestration. Hope you are not following many points you have to catch. Now, polyamine acids, polyphosphates, and EDTA added to hard water. In hard water, calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2 are there. They are free. They are reacting with water, soap, and with other materials. But what you are doing now? By the addition of this amino acids, polyphosphates, EDTA to the hard water, calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2, linked by this one, they are not free. They are not free in the water. Their activity is suppressed. their activity is suppressed, their activity is prevented, then they are free from calcium plus 10, magnesium plus 2. Therefore, that water not acting as hard water. That water acts as water, soft water. Calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2, they are in water, but they are not showing their activity. That particular process is what is called? Come on.
Sequestration.
Not getting the point. Amino acids, polyphosphates, EDTA added to the hard water. The calcium plus 2, this is calcium plus 2. This is calcium plus 2. This is what amino acid or polyphosphate or EDTA. This is EDTA, imagine. This is calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2. It is linked to this one. Before the addition, it is free. It is showing its activity. After the addition of this one, it is linked to this one. It cannot show its activity. Its activity is what? Suppressed or prevented. This process, what you call?
Sequestration.
Sequestration. By this, the hard water is not behaving like hard water. The hard water behaves like soft water. This particular process, what you call? Sequestration. For example, from a well, a bucket of water is taken. From a well, bucket of water you are taking. You are trying to wash the clothes. You are trying to wash the clothes with rinse soap. With rinse soap. You are not getting any float. The rinse soap is not working. The rinse soap is not cleaning your clothes. Then what you do? You are adding EDTA. You are adding EDTA. This is EDTA. You are added to bucket of water. There is calcium plus 2. Magnesium plus 2 are bonded. Magnesium plus 2 are bonded. There is no free magnesium plus 2 and calcium plus 2. Then soap cannot interact with this one. Calcium plus 2 and magnesium plus 2 cannot interact with soap. Therefore, now again try to wash the clothes. The water is getting large amount of float. That means what? The calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2 activity is what? Suppressed, prevented. That process what you call?
Sequestration.
To follow all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Polyamine acids, polyphosphates, EDTA in the bracket, EDTA in the bracket, ethylenamine tetraacetato, aceto, that is, the complexing or chelating agents are added to hard water. The calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2 form a soluble complex. They are there in the solution. Form soluble complex. By this, their activity is suppressed. As a result, hot water behaves like soft water. Next, sequestration, cyanidic. Suppression of activity of activity of calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2 in hard water. Calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2 in hard water. Hard water by adding complexing or chelating agents. Complexing or chelating agents known as sequestration. Note, sequestration method is also applied for the boiler purpose. Next, so removal of temporary hardness, three methods. Come on, what are the methods? Boiling, somebody, boiling.
Boiling, Clark's method. Addition of complexing agents or chelating agents.
Chelating. Method one, sequestration. Next, sir, removal of permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. Permanent hardness. In this inorganic, ion exchange method. Inorganic ion exchange method. Under this, one, geolite process. Geolite process. Look here. This is also part of permutate process. Permutate. Geolite process. Permutate process. Look here. In this process, Sodium geolite, that is, with the word, Na2O, Na2O3, and SiO2, NH2. This process, sodium geolite, this is the formula of sodium geolite. This is also commonly called as permutate. This is actually a chemical compound taken into a big stainless steel cylinder. You might have seen in some of the apartments also, glass panels or apartments, you might have seen, but you don't have any idea about units. The top floor, the groundwater is pumped into water tank. Before they enter into the water tank, the water is passed through this particular geolite. This sodium geolite in this, the big stainless steel tank. In this, this is powder and tightly packed. Powder and tightly packed like this. Tightly packed. And the bore water, the groundwater is actually allowed to pass through this. Allowed to pass through this. There will be a inlet and also outlet for this. Inlet and outlet. Right? Now, what I'm going to see. Area 2O, Area 2O3, Area 2O2. EMH2O, see the border. Through this is what sodium geolite. Through this, you are passing the groundwater. Groundwater carries different types of minerals and calcium, magnesium, bicarbonate, chloride, sulfate. These are many things are there, right? Through this, you are passing hot water and groundwater. This is now what you see plus calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2, hot water. Magnesium plus hard water. Then, while passing through this, the calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2, either word, calcium plus 2 or magnesium plus 2, substituting any plus sounds. Here, whatever the dots I put, they're all about any plus sounds. Some lakhs and millions of any plus sounds are there. While hard water is passing through this, calcium plus 2, magnesium plus 2 sounds, substituting any plus sounds. Any plus sounds get substituted. But calcium plus 2 magnesium is stuck there. Calcium plus 2 magnesium plus 2 is stuck up there only. They are not coming out. Only Na plus ions come out. So, this is now converting into water. This is CaO. Na2O converting into what? CaO now. CaO. Al2O3. Look carefully. NSiO2. MH2. CaO, Al2O3, NSiO2. MH2 plus Na plus cells, 2 Na plus cells plus 2 Na plus cells coming out. Now, look here carefully. Now, if you are passing continuously 10 days, 20 days, 30 days, 1 month, 1.5 months, like that, hard water you are passing through this, then how many Na plus cells we can expect that? A million or billion only. Daily, 1000 and thousands of Na plus ions substituted by calcium plus 2. After 1.5 months, all the Na plus ions are substituted by Ca plus 2 or Na plus 2. After 1.5 months, all the Ca plus 2, Na plus 2 ions are substituting Na plus ions. Then after some time, there is no Na plus ion. All the Na plus ions get exhausted. Then, once you are passing hard water, you will be getting hard water. There is no substitution because Na plus ions are exhausted. Therefore, the cylinder, the company which is supplying the cylinder to you, there will be some guidelines. There will be some guidelines. You cannot get every time, or every 1.5 months, you cannot change. So you can re-originate the sodium geolite. You can re-originate the sodium geolite. How to originate? There will be guideline. What guideline? Do this. This is now. This is what sodium geolite. This is what exhausted geolite is. Exhausted geolite. Now, through this, then the guideline. What guideline? Through this, pass saturated sodium chloride solution. Through this, now to pass saturated sodium chloride solution for about few hours. For about 2-3 hours, continuously, you have to pass sodium chloride through this. Then, Na plus ion substitute calcium. Na plus ion substitute calcium. Then you are getting original permittivity or original sodium chloride. In this way, you can re-originate and continuously you can use this particular sodium chloride for years to come. 3, how? We are using sodium zeolite and we are converting the groundwater, the hard water into soft water. Which is a process what we call zeolite process or permutate process. Zeolite process or permutate process. Come on, take it. For all of you, are any doubt?
Understood, sir.
Or no?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Sodium zeolite, right now, sodium zeolite formula, Na2O, Cl2O3, NSiO2, MH2O. Ready, sodium zeolite or permutate, both are same. Sodium zeolite or permutate. Or permutate. Right. Sodium zeolite or permutate packed into a stainless steel cylinder. Packed into a stainless steel cylinder. Stainless steel cylinder. Groundwater is allowed to pass through it. The calcium plus 2 or Mg plus 2 ions. Substitute Na plus ions. Substitute Na plus ions as a result, hard water changing to soft water. Take it. Sodium zeolite, hard water, exhausted.
got, sir.
Good day, Jay.
Yes, sir.
Right. Take one point already, you know this one. Our continuous passing of hard water. On continuous passing of hard water. Through sodium dioxide. After some time, all the Na plus ions get substituted. All the Na plus ions get substituted by Ca plus 2 or Fe plus 2. Ca plus 2 or Fe plus 2. And it gets exhausted. Exhausted. Then it will not perform properly. Properly. Next point. Next. To re-originate the exhausted dioxide. Dioxide. Pass. Saturated sodium chloride solution. For about few hours. Any plus ions displace calcium plus 2 Fe plus 2 ions. And again, sodium chloride reproduce. And it can be reused again. Right. I'll get it out tomorrow. Thank you.